Live at Cowboys Stadium in Arlington. Great to have you with us. The finale of three big football games here on a busy Saturday in Arlington. Right now, let's check in with Jim Knox. He's standing by with Allen head coach Tom Westerberg.
Coach, Houston Lamar's defense is known for not giving up many points. How do you move the football against them tonight?
You know, we're not going to do anything different than we've done in the last 5 weeks. You know, we're going to let our offensive linemen up front turn loose a little bit, see if we can get the ball going up downfield a little.
Kyler Murray, the young sophomore, gets a start at quarterback. Any concerns in playing in an atmosphere like this?
None at all. He's a pretty smooth character. We were in a big stage last Saturday night, and he handled that well. I don't think it's going to be any different tonight.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, very good. Thank you very much, Jim. We'll be checking in with Jim Knox throughout the evening, along with Neil Beasley as well. Lamar Redskins won the toss, Jay, but they've deferred, so they'll kick it off to the Allen Eagles. Chad Adams back, number 5. Mayomi Olutu, number 4, also back for the Allen Eagles. Big crowd continues to build. They had over 46,000 for the game just completed.
Well, they're expecting more for this. Was.
Yeah. We are off and running here at Cowboys Stadium. Great to have you with us tonight. Chad Adams fields it. It is down at the 16-yard line. So Allen will begin this football game on offense. Coming in again, 14-1. Kyler Murray, sophomore. Got a heck of a job taking over in this Allen offense. Transfer in, and his numbers speak for themselves. Almost 2,000 yards there.
But he transferred in August, Randy, so yep. No spring training, nothing but fall camp, and has played really well at the quarterback spot and is kind of learning the offense still, and he's a very potent weapon.
There's Murray. He'll keep it, crossing the 15. He is brought down just shy by John Bonney. Take a look at the four starting lineups now. Let's begin with the Allen Eagles. Marcus Ward, we featured him at the top. Troy Knutson, good wide receiver, along with Cole Carter, Oliver Pierce, and Cameron Cowcoat. Up front, North, Wortham, Peroma, Clark, and Camp. Clearing some space.
With a very good offensive
time.
Line for
Excellent
Allen.
Offensive line. Good size up front. Second down and 7 now. Nearly picked off. Kyler Murray looking over the middle. Kyron Mitchell got a hand on it. Four defensive starting lineups now for the Lamar Redskins. Up front, Brandon Martinez, Ira Lewis, a standout along with Zelt Miner. We featured him at the top. Rogers, Mitchell, and Gibson, the linebacking core for the Redskins. 3rd and 7 now. Kyler Murray in trouble, and down he goes. Ira Lewis with the sack for the Redskins.
Well, Randy, we featured the defense for this Lamar team at the open. And they win the toss, choose to go on defense first. Great pressure there by Ira Lewis. Coming in on the young quarterback for the sack and just fighting through a block there. Good job, and that really negative play puts Allen deep and punting from about 5 yards deep in their own end zone. And it's a high snap, Randy.
Already trouble for Allen.
Safety.
The snap to Shane Trapuka. And a miscue early for the Allen Eagles. And a safety for Lamar. They're on the board. Take a look at it again here, Shane.
They credit the defense there for forcing the punt and pinning the Allen Eagles deep. And anytime that you're punting from your own end zone, there's always a little bit of disruption and cause for uncomfort. Snap sailed over the top of the punter's head, and Lamar not only gets 2 points, but obviously they're going to get the ball back on this kick from the 20-yard line.
Anthony McGaffin responsible for that snap.
And certainly not the start that Coach Tom Westerberg wanted to have in this game.
You don't want to give away any points in a game with this magnitude on. So 2-0 Lamar on the board. Like a baseball score already. They'll take it, though. Yeah, good shot right there of the crowd that's assembled here at Cowboys Stadium. It's a big deal when you're crowned as state football champions in this state.
Well, they've had great crowds. As you said, Randy, the culmination of a state championship extravaganza with tonight's game. We kicked off this broadcast on Fox Sports at 12 noon on Thursday, and we're still going strong.
Three games each day. So Lamar will kick it off. Carlos Orochi. Ronnie Wesley. Shelby Walker actually with the return for Lamar, so they'll get the football back in pretty good shape as they come take over on offense for the first time. And there's a quarterback, Darrell Colbert. He's a junior. 5'10", 165, 170. Good numbers this season. There they are, 2,333 yards, 28 touchdowns for Colbert. He's been leading this offense his last year as a sophomore.
And when you talk to Coach Nolan and you ask him about number seven, he makes it pretty quick and pretty simple, as he is known to do. He said he's the best player on our team.
He relies on.
So tell me about it, Bill. He's the best player on our team.
So, all right, what else do you want to know?
I got it.
There, Culver's pass intended for Bo Wells.
Randy, I tell you what, that was a heck of a throw from the right hash all the way across the field. Bo Wells, you see, working against man coverage. Alutu, very nice coverage right there. Wells makes a diving grab, but not able to come up with the catch.
Bo Wells, one of the seniors on this offense. A lot of young players offensively as well, especially up front on that offensive line for Lamar. Second down and 10 now from the 40-yard line for the Redskins. Hand off to Ronnie Wesley. And he is brought down quickly. That's Byron Bonds with the tackle. Ford starting lineup for the Lamar Redskins. Wesley Mitchell Stewart. Shelby Walker's a good one. We mentioned Bo Wells. Senior receiver up front. Wilson, Bodion, Hyder, Whitfield, and Barner. And one senior on that offensive line for Lamar. That's a loss of two after that carry to Ronnie Wesley. So second, third down and 12 now from the 38-yard line. Pressure on Colbert. Pass intended for Shelby Walker. Coverage on the play by Michael Jacob. They want a flag. No flag down, though, for the officials. Take a look at the Ford starting lineups defensively for the Allen Eagles. Up front, Williams, Bonds, already been active, Marcus Davis, Bishop Walker, Cobb, and Tay Evans, weak side linebacker. In the secondary, a lot of playmakers. Naomi Olotu, he's a good one. And there he is, number four. Bradley and Cincy will punt it away for the Redskins back at the 29. Oliver Pierce back to receive for the Allen Eagles. It's a good bounce. Pierce finally brought down. Helmet come flying off. Back just crossing the 20-yard line. So 2-0 Lamar lead. 9:59 to go first quarter. And the Allen offense will take over once again. Kyler Murray, 5'10", 160 pounds, just under 2,000 passing yards, Shade. 16 touchdowns, only 5 interceptions all year. Protected the football well.
In his rushing yards, Randy, he's over 1,200 yards rushing, averaging around 7 yards a carry and 23 touchdowns. So think about what this guy does, and you have to certainly make sure that you keep him in front of you.
And off to Marcus Ward. He spins, crossing the 30. He's brought down by John Bonney. On safety for the Redskins. Marcus Ward, the senior.
Yeah, very tough runner, as you talked about at the outset. Over 1,400 yards on the season. After filling in for Jeff Harris, he's done a great job. Murray on the keeper.
It's outside near the 35-yard line. Enough for a first down. They'll mark it at the 36-yard line. Chains will move for the Eagles. Tom Westerberg, ninth year as head coach at Allen. Overall record of 101-16.
Marcus Ward again. He's tripped up. I mean, it was a good first down runs by this Allen offense. Previously, Ward picked up about 7 or 8 yards on first down. Murray picked up the first down after that on second, but Ward rips off about 5 yards, so it's nice to be getting a little bit of rhythm going offensively for Allen.
Pass is caught out to Kendall Clinton. He's brought down by Cedric Lancaster.
Oh, what a tackle there by Lancaster in open field. Kendall Clinton had a lot of room out there, a lot of space. Lancaster hadn't really closed down from that safety position, and just a great job of form tackling. I mean, you can't coach it or teach it any better than that.
On his way to SMU along with Zell Miner. Hand off Marcus Ward, nothing there. Speaking of Zell Miner, there he is making the stop.
Well, what a force, 6'2", 240 pounds, athletic. Gets off of blocks extremely well, uses his hands. And defensive linemen, that's one of the things that you'll see, the really good ones know how to use their hands and their leverage. Zell Miner is advancing on that status already.
Second down at 14. That's Cole Carter with the catch. Tell you what, Kyler Murray awfully patient there in the pocket with the pressure closing in on him.
Well, you saw the double team there on Miner, keeping him out of the backfield. And that allows Murray to step up into the pocket and throw the ball to Cole Carter for the first down.
First catch of the night for Carter. Pickup of 17 yards. Kyler Murray feeling the heat, but got that pass off. First and 10 now from the 41-yard line. He'll hand it once again to Marcus Ward, but he runs right into Kyron Mitchell.
That was a big hit right there. And this is a place that we've seen Marcus Ward rip off for 5, 6, 7, 8 yards. He tries to cut that one back up in the middle. He runs right into Mitchell. Very physical defense.
Two seniors in that linebacking corps. Mitchell's the underclassman, but he's only a junior. Second down and 9 now for the 40. Murray. Pass intended for Grant Finney, overthrown there around the inside the 10-yard line. Good coverage on the play by Derek Carmucci. Third down play now coming up for the Eagles.
And that's why this Redskins defense is so incredibly tough, and gonna get an offsides here. Hard count. There are 3, maybe 4 Lamar defenders.
Offsides on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
Well, makes it third down and 4 now coming up for Allen. Officiating crew for the ball game tonight from the Tyler chapter. We talk about it each and every game. This is a great opportunity for these officials, great officials across the state of Texas. Officiate on the big screen. That pass intended for Kendall Clinton. Just off the mark a little bit from Kyler Murray.
It would have been enough for the first down had Clinton been able to hang on to it. Gets him right in the mitts. Maybe just a little bit to the outside for him. That's a grab that Clinton would expect to have. Over 30 catches on the year. He's made big plays, and this Allen offense going for it, Randy, on 4th and 4.
Yeah, from the 35-yard line. Kyler Murray overthrown. Intended receiver was Kendall Clinton. And he'll turn it over on downs. Lamar will take over.
Well, in no man's land, really. Obviously, too far away to kick a field goal.
Time out.
Certainly too close to punt the ball, so understand why they go for it on 4th down.
We'll take a break. 7:26 to go, first quarter. 2-0 Lamar. We're coming right back. Eagles trail 2-0, but what a night here. A lot of football left here as we crown a 5A Division I state champion. Our second series of the football game. They'll start it on their own 35-yard line. Hand off to Ronnie Wesley. He got a little room. And then knocked just shy of the 40-yard line by Nick Cobb, bandit linebacker of the Allen Eagle defense.
Well, and Cobb is just such an important player to this defense, as are so many other guys, but he's a three-time state champ as a wrestler, Randy, and he's 5'11", 220 pounds. He's got good closing speed, as you see him put the hit on Wesley.
Picks up three. Second and seven now from the 38. Corey Mitchell's in motion. Bill Colbert will keep it. But he is swarmed quickly. That's Nick Cobb again. And his Eagle teammates on the stop of Colbert along with Jordan Ratcliffe. Check in now with Neil Beasley. Neil.
Hey, thanks, guys. You see this Redskin defense over here behind me. And once again, on that last drive, they were tested, but like they have all year, did not break. This is a group that's given up only 21 points combined in the last three games. 13 takeaways just in the playoffs alone. Let's see how much they will bend but not break this game, guys.
Yeah, so defense certainly carried up, creating those turnovers.
It's been just an amazing story for this team.
It really has been.
You go back to that old adage, Randy, defense wins championships, and they've got a great one here at Lamar.
Third and nine now from the 36. Colbert in trouble. And down he goes at the 35-yard line by Byron Bonds.
Randy, great pressure by this Eagles defense. Great coverage downfield as well. Colbert makes a decision that he wants to run, but when you look at all the blue jerseys around him, led by Jordan Ratcliffe, and then Byron Bonds comes in to clean up. That's a lot of blue jerseys around and not a whole lot of room to move. Talk about this Lamar defense. How about the Allen defense?
Stepping up so far. Bradley Nincensee in there to punt. Oliver Pierce back to receive. He's set up around the 30-yard line. Nincensee's punt. That'll go out of bounds. Yeah, pretty close to the 30. They'll mark it at the 29-yard line. Take a look at some of the rushing numbers, if we can, from Kyler Murray, the quarterback, and, of course, Marcus Ward, the senior. Sophomore and senior, monster numbers combining there for 38 touchdowns between the two of them.
Well, it's just been a great job by those two young men, but Randy, I would go back and point to that offensive line, as I guarantee you both of those guys would. And
I get credit right away.
Big, experienced front.
Marcus Moore hit it up in the middle, and there's a flag down. It missed maybe a late hit on Kyler Murray. Brandon Martinez, Ira Lewis on the stop, but after the throw, Murray took a pretty big shot. We'll see if that's what the flag's all about.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness on the defense, be a 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, automatic first down.
Yeah, late hit indeed on the quarterback, Kyler Murray. Here it is.
Got hit after he handed the ball off. And for defensive coordinator Ernie Salvador and head coach Tom Nolan, not happy to see those 15 yards.
First and 10 from the 44-yard line. Murray. Kyron Mitchell with the stop for the Lamar defense. Brandon Martinez also involved. Kind of grind it out here. 4:40 and counting, first quarter here at Cowboys Stadium. 2-0 Redskins after the early safety. Hand off to Ward.
Randy, we saw that offensive line for Allen opening up some holes on the previous drive, and the adjustments on defense by the Redskins right now. I mean, they're making it very, very difficult. Shooting the gaps. You got white jerseys every time you approach the line of scrimmage, and you got a very physical defense. Kyron Mitchell, the middle linebacker, scraping off and meeting Ward at the line of scrimmage.
Kyler Murray looking downfield. There's nothing there, but he escapes the traffic, crossing midfield, past the 40, down to the 15, the 10, 5, touchdown, Kyler Murray. Scamper for the young sophomore.
Kyler Murray doing an awesome job right there of making guys miss, was good pressure by that Lamar defense. The pocket started to collapse, and he almost paused, it looked like, Randy, for just a second before he took off. Once he got on the edge, waltzed into the end zone.
One after is good by Carlos Orochi. Worth another look here from this angle.
Yeah, good coverage downfield by the defensive backs. Just that elusive move. Bounced out. Looked like he was going to try to go wide, but he decides to cut it right back up the middle and hits the sidelines for the score.
Nice shot from that sky cam, I might add. We got the sky cam hooked up here tonight.
Oh, that's fantastic. Great shot there. And Kyler Murray getting a good block downfield. Great vision. And you talk about this guy, and you know, you said it earlier, a young sophomore. Just turned 15 years old a couple of weeks ago.
24th rushing touchdown this season. Going up quickly here. Four plays, 71 yards on that drive. Minute 25 off the clock. Kyler Murray closing it out on that 55-yard touchdown run. Kick it off. Cedric Lancaster, number one, is back. Also Ronnie Wesley. Lancaster will field it at the 21. We'll follow his blockers crossing. 25 down to the 30. Still on his feet. Brought down near the 35-yard line. Nice return by Cedric Lancaster. Check in right now with Jim Knox alongside the Allen sideline. Jim.
All right, Randy, I think that unnecessary roughness penalty on Lamar's defense really fired up Kyler Murray, because you saw a spark in him after he made that touchdown. He came to the bench, and you never seen emotion out of Kyler Murray. Usually a calm, cool, and collected kid, but he was fired up after that one. Also, I talked to him before the game. I said, you never played in an atmosphere like this. Are you going to be a little wide-eyed on this one? He said, no way. I played against South Lake Carroll. I played against DeSoto last week. That prepared me for the game like this.
Heavyweights on their schedule throughout the season, no doubt about that. He's put on some
prior
clinic
snap,
right there on that 55-yard.
False start on the offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Yeah, Tom Nolan doesn't like seeing that. Push it back 5 yards. 3:38 mark of the first quarter. 7-2 now, Allen on top. Culver trying to hand it off to Ronnie Wesley. A little confusion on that exchange. Jordan Ratcliffe in on the stop. A little help with Jack Hawkins as well.
Get ready to look like Darrell Colbert after faking the handoff to Ronnie Wesley. Was going to be able to pick up some yards, and it looks like there's space, and then it just converges. Jack Hawkins coming in and making sure that Colbert cannot get started.
Second down and 14 now. Loss of 4. Mark it at the 30-yard line. Colbert. Pass intended for Shelby Walker. He's overthrown a little bit. Lamar having some issues. Get some consistency going here on offense tonight.
Well, Shelby Walker, the leading receiver on the team. Only 5'9", and Colbert sailed that ball a little too high.
Lamar made the trip up. Actually, some teams traveled day of, like Katie earlier, but Lamar came up yesterday as a team, and of course, waiting all day to play. He's got to test your patience a little bit. Colbert has some running room, crossing the 40, 45. Finally brought down around the 47-yard line. Chad Adams with the stop for Allen.
There is a great job here by Darrell Colbert. He recognizes man coverage downfield, so all the defenders' backs are turned. Once he breaks through the line of scrimmage, he's able to go forward and pick up the first down. So on third and about 14 yards, Colbert comes up big with a first down run.
after the play was over, personal foul on the offense, the 15-yard penalty. They entertained their line to gain, so it'll be a first down, Houston Lamar.
Take a look at it again. Colbert on the run here. He's going to take a hit. And down he goes at the 47-yard line. Not sure about the flag. Who's responsible for that?
Again, Colbert doing a great job of recognizing man coverage. Defenders had their backs turned running with the receivers from Lamar. And Colbert was able to convert on third and 14, picking up the first down.
First down now. They push it back to the 32-yard line. Here's Ronnie Wesley. He's got running room, crossing the 40-yard line.
One of the few times that we've seen Corey Mitchell, fullback, lined up in the same backfield as Wesley. So going to a two-back set, establishing the run game, running over that right side. Wesley's got some wheels, man. 922 yards coming into the game. And this team, Randy, has rushed for over 2,400 yards, and not a single rusher is over 1,000.
Another big hole for Wesley, crossing midfield. He's hit by Tay Evans. Also, Mayomi Olutu. And there's a balanced attack when you look at that. Rushing over 2,400 yards. Passing game, not too shabby either. 157 average per game.
Can you see why Darrell Colbert gets such high praise from Coach Tom Nolan, is getting the ball to the playmakers and making plays on your own.
Second out at five now. Pass is caught. That's Bo Wells. Inside the 35-yard line. Coverage by Michael Jacob. Plenty of time to throw the football this play for Darrell Colbert.
Little complimentary route right there. I like the way that Bo Wells put that little double, the threat of the double move, as he kind of stutter-stepped and act like he was going to take off, and then he breaks it back in on the curl route underneath. Nice pitch and catch for the first down.
Well, Redskins marching down here. Late first quarter from the 32-yard line. First and 10 now. Hand off to Wesley.
Ooh, Nick Cobb and crew around the line of scrimmage.
Right there to greet him. Nick Cobb, 5'11", 220-pound senior, one of the captains on this Allen defense. Five sacks on the season. Cobb's also, you don't want to mess with him on the wrestling mat either.
Absolutely not. Three times.
Yeah.
State champ.
He knows how to win that hardware. Talk a little more tonight. Colbert out to Bo Wells. Pass is caught. He'll be brought down, though. Drive the 30-yard line by Deontay Meeking. Yeah, you're talking to defensive coordinator for Allen, Corey Kane, or head coach Westerberg. When they talk about Nick Cobb, they said it all starts with him on that defense. He's the leader out there. He's the playmaker.
Well, there's a bunch of playmakers on the team, but Cobb's certainly one of them.
He kind of leads the pack out there. Well, Lamar's going to take a timeout here, third and 10.
Timeout. Houston Lamar, their first charge timeout of the half.
Their first of the game. You got two left here in the half. They'll talk it over from the 32-yard line.
Right now, just feeling from the ebb and the flow of the game, Randy, this is feels like it's in a very important drive for this Lamar team. Although they got the 2 points on the board on the errant snap to punter, Allen comes back after a couple of series, scores a touchdown on the long run by Kyler Murray. But you feel like this Lamar offense, giving their defense a little bit of a break, moving the ball downfield and having some success running, this third down is going to be an important one for them.
Well, it's been a long time coming for any school from Houston Independent School District to make it here to play for a state championship. The last Houston ISD state champion, Jack Yates High School, 1985. That happened to be the first year that Tom Nolan arrived on the Lamar campus. He's been there ever since.
Well, that was a great Lions team in 1985.
Yeah.
Bringing home the hardware, but it has been a long drought for the HISD.
28 years as head coach at Lamar for Tom Nolan. The veteran, the dean of coaches there in HISD. Now Derek Culbert. Pass intended for Cedric Lancaster on that. First pass tip to Lancaster tonight.
Well, Lancaster was lined up as the inside receiver on the three receiver side. Did a good job of making a post move. Breaks it back out to the corner. Dante Meeking, not bad coverage. The ball just a little beyond the stretch there of Lancaster. So now Lamar, Randy, finds himself kind of in that no man's land.
Now fourth and 10. They're going to go for it here from the 32-yard line. Redskins trying to convert. Colbert. Pass to Bowell. Nearly brought in. Falls incomplete. Coverage on the play by Michael Jacob.
Well, on fourth down, Darrell Colbert gets forced out of the pocket just a little bit. And I think that's what forced the throw to be a little outside of Bo Wells' reach. Defender right in his face. The Allen defense holds on fourth down. And Corey Kane, defensive coordinator, you mentioned this earlier. He's in his seventh year with Coach Westerberg at Allen. And if you ask Coach Westerberg, you say, hey, he has done a masterful job of dialing up blitzes.
Kyler Murray, he's got running room. Nobody is going to catch Murray. Touchdown, Allen. 68 yards of the touchdown run for the Allen sophomore.
Murray scrambled on that first touchdown run, Randy, with the packet collapsing around him. This is a design run the whole way. Fakes the zone read, sees a gap there on the left, and he goes untouched.
Extra point is up. Extra point is good by Carlos Orochi. There's a shot. Kyler Murray, focused to the end zone. 55-yarder and now a 68-yard touchdown run for the Eagles' sophomore quarterback.
This Allen offense with a lot of weapons. Talk about the trigger man, Kyler Murray, but Marcus Ward, how about that? Two carries, 123 yards.
Pretty good average right there, right?
Not too shabby. And two very different plays. The first one was under duress, and it was more of a freelance play where he had to make a bunch of guys miss in the backfield before he made it to the sideline and walked into the end zone. This particular one was a good job of blocking at the point of attack by that offensive line on the zone read. Murray fakes the ball in the belly of Marcus Ward, pulls it back, cuts to the left, and off to the races. Lamar, Randy, switching up their return just a little bit.
Yeah, John Bonney's out there now, number four.
Well, Cedric Lancaster is deep, but they moved Ronnie Wesley up around that 25-yard line where they've been trying to pooch the ball, and it looks like Wesley's going to get this.
Wesley from the 24-yard line. He's still on his feet, looking for a block. He's backtracking a little bit, trying to turn the corner. It just passed the 20-yard line before he's brought down. Tackle made by Jazz Henderson, number 19 of Allen.
Well, Wesley was trying desperately to make something happen. Kept bouncing it out and bouncing wide, but that Allen special teams play did a fantastic job of not allowing him to make the corner. When he couldn't get to the edge, he ended up giving up about maybe 7 or 8 yards off of where he would have been from where he fielded the ball.
6 seconds left in this opening quarter. 14-2 lead now for Allen. An encouraging drive. Last time Lamar had the football, they marched it down. Of course, fell a little short when they went for it on fourth down. The confidence building. They were able to move the chains a little bit. Culver will keep. And down he goes. That's Nick Cobb again. He's had a great opening quarter here at Arlington tonight. And on that play, zeros after first quarter of action here at Cowboys Stadium. Zeros on the scoreboard. We're going to quarter number two. The Allen Eagles behind Kyler Murray. They lead Lamar 14-2. Welcome back, Cowboys Stadium, 14-2. Allen on top of Lamar as we start the second quarter here at Cowboys Stadium. Very big crowd gathering here for the 5A Division I state championship. Summer here, that all started with that safety.
Well, the safety started it, but Kyler Murray has so far been the highlight reel of the game. Again, breaking containment on that nice scramble play on third and long. Then on the next possession, Randy, zone replay. Murray reads it perfectly, waltzes into the end zone untouched on a 68-yard scamper.
Kyler Murray, very productive start. All smiles right now as his Eagles lead at 14-2. Looking down at 15 now for the Redskins. Culver will dump it off. Corey Mitchell, though, is met very quickly by Jack Hawkins.
Yeah, trying on right there. Second and long, trying to go with the little screen pass. Now the Corey Mitchell's got 18 catches, averages 20 yards a snag, but Jack Hawkins reads it perfectly and lowers the boom on Mitchell. That was a heads-up play there. Third and 17 now for this Lamar offense.
Way back at the 15-yard line. Colbert looking downfield. That's going to find. That's Dejon Druitt, his first catch of the night.
But Druitt, not a very big guy, 5'7", 155 pounds. Going Darryl Colbert, Randy. He's trying to clear the cobwebs right now.
Personal foul, roughing the passer on the defense, 15 yards from the end of the run, automatic first down.
And Colbert trying to shake off the cobwebs. He took a big shot there after the pass play.
Take another look at it here from the sky cam view. There's Culbert. There's a big hit delivered by Zach Bishop.
Yeah, popping the head. It's they're going to get the hit helmet to helmet. Personal foul. Does give the Lamar offense, though, a very important first down because they would not have picked it up on the pass play to Druitt.
Yeah, gives them a little breathing room after the 36. That's Wesley with the carry. He's brought down by Cameron Hartsfield.
We've not called Hartsfield's name so far in this game, but he is the leading tackler on this Allen defense out of that free safety spot.
Mark it out to the 44-yard line. So a nice 8-yard pickup there by Ronnie Wesley. Second and short now. 2 yards to go for the first down. Over to get out to Wesley. Pulled down just shy of the 50. Stop made by Christian Sam.
Well, Christian Sam, number two, in hot pursuit on Ronnie Wesley. Ooh, got away with the face mask
yeah,
there.
Yeah, that was close. Sam's got 10 sacks this year. Very active junior, 6 foot, 195 pounder. Will linebacker for the Eagles.
A lot of speed, Randy, on this Allen defense. Coach Westerberg and Corey Kane told us that this is the fastest secondary ever in the history of Allen. Closing down and getting around the ball. Zach Bishop again on the tackle on Wesley.
Early second quarter here, 9:43 and counting. Cowboys Stadium in Arlington. Second down and 10 now for the Redskins. They'll mark it on the 49-yard line. And 14-2, trying to get something consistency going. There's Colbert. Got a little running room inside the 40. Inside the 30-yard line.
Yeah, Randy, it was a very patient run there by Colbert. And it looked like he was going to run the entire time. But what he did was kind of let the flow go away from him. Looked off to his right. Makes the run back on that left side.
22-yard pickup for Darrell Colbert on that play. First and 10 now from the 28. Pleasure to be joined by UIL Director of Athletics, Dr. Mark Cousins. Good to see you again.
Appreciate the time to come up and talk to you guys.
You've been a busy guy in the staff for the last few days. It's been a lot of fun, though.
There's no question about that. Being able to close it out with this 5A Division I championship game, it's really closing out just a fabulous weekend of Texas high school football.
Not much there for Lamar. Brings up second down. Talk about this crowd. You look around, and Shay and I were just talking about it. I mean, three levels deep here. I don't know if you got a final tally yet, but this is a very nice turnout tonight.
Well, we're going to wait as long as we can to let everybody that wants to come in, and I think we're going to go around and count them one by one.
There you go.
But, man, what a fabulous day we've had. I mean, I'm not sure how much is in the bottom three, but it's got to be well over 40,000 stupid people that came in to watch this game. So just the climax of a great weekend. Crowds have been fabulous both Thursday, Friday, and today. So we couldn't be more excited about the way this has ended up.
Second down and 10 for the 28.
That's out for ball handling.
Yeah, it's Nicholas Turner on the reception there for Lamar, his first catch of the night. Yeah, we had heard an earlier figure of 46,000 for the other game, but, of course, nothing confirmed. But there seems like a lot more have come in on this one, a very nice crowd. And an element to this football game, the Skycam, the first ever high school football game to use the Skycam. And we've seen it in action already tonight.
Man, how exciting is that? I mean, I found myself, like a lot of other people here in the stadium, actually watching the screens or watching the TV to get the shot of it. What a great opportunity for these kids to play in this kind of game, in this kind of facility, with the technology and things that are available for NFL games. What an exciting time it's got to be. And it's great, again, for Texas high school football. We're just excited to be a part of it.
Third and eight now. Colbert chased out of the pocket. There's a flag down around the 28-yard line. Colbert out of bounds. Around the 20. He's down by Marcus Davis.
Yeah, it's going to go against Ronnie Wesley, Randy. So he goes back and he makes a cutback block on Christian Sam. Sam coming out of that outside linebacker spot was what forced Colbert out of the pocket. A very athletic, very fast.
On the offense, 10-yard penalty, still third down.
That'll push it back.
Not sure where the hole was, but Christian Sam was wreaking a lot of havoc in the backfield.
Dr. Cousins, talk a little bit about the reaction you guys continue to get over the last 3 days. Because as you look back to last year, I know y'all started planning, and, hey, let's make it even better. And it seems like everything's come off without a hit.
Yeah, that's one of the great – it's just a testament to the folks here at Cowboys Stadium, Bruce Hardy, Brett Daniels, Travis Clark, and the staff, and then the folks in our office that worked so hard to put this together. Couldn't do it without our assistant athletic directors, Darrell Beasley, Tracy Kneeler, Peter Contreras down on the field, keeping everything moving, and certainly in the other assistants in our office, Lisa Hughes, Rebecca Quinlan, Jessica Lane, and Bree Davis, all right. Do a fabulous job.
Before the snap, false start on the offense, 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Yeah, we're just lucky to have a staff that's able to put this thing together and help us be here and make sure everything goes as smoothly as possible. So all these coaches have to worry about it, what happens down there on the field. We try to take care of many of the details as we can for them so they can coach football and try to win them a state championship.
And having the games here in one venue but in a controlled environment so weather's not a factor, because when you're playing for a state title, you don't need that distraction.
Well, and that's certainly the two biggest things that we've talked about with having all these games at one place. You got to have climate control, and you got to have an artificial turf surface. Mm-hmm. Certainly along with that, the number of locker rooms to be able to play these number of games. You got to have four full-size locker rooms, and this is a great facility to host this event.
They're down at 23 for the 41. Homer dumped it off. That's Corey Mitchell. In for the touchdown, the Lamar Redskins strike. Big play for Colbert here, Shay.
Randy, third and 23. And Colbert gets flushed out of the pocket again by number two, Christian Sam. And as he bounces out to his left, keeps his eyes downfield, finds Corey Mitchell. And I said earlier, 18 catches on the season, averaging 20 yards a catch.
right there comes up huge for the Redskins offense.
One after tip coming up from Alan Melgar of Lamar. Snap is good. And the kick is also actually no good. No good. Extra point is missed. So it's a 14-8 lead now for Allen. But Lamar with the big touchdown run. Corey Mitchell.
The Tappers.
Ultimate VIP experience. By DQ for the best tasting treats, eats, and drinks in Texas. DQ just tastes better. And by your Texas Ford dealer. Stop by and find out why the F-Series trucks are the best in Texas. Welcome back live, Cowboys Stadium in Arlington. Corey Mitchell with the touchdown. 14-8 Allen lead. Continue to be joined by Director of Athletics at UIL, Dr. Mark Cousins. And what's ahead now? After you wrap up the game today, the work never stops. So they get a little bit of a break for the holidays.
Yeah, we'll get a little bit of break for the holidays and come back in the spring. And, man, that's when it really kicks off. We've already had a pretty good year so far with our volleyball and team tennis and cross country. Certainly winding up this semester here with football. But then we roll in, you know, basketball season just started district. We get into the spring with our first championships being our swimming and diving and wrestling state championships. Then we go basketball for 2 weeks, and then we roll right on to soccer, track and field, softball, and baseball to close out the year.
Yeah, you mentioned wrestling as the kickoff is brought in by Naomi Olutu. He brought down. Good special teams effort by Lamar. Take another look at the touchdown. By Lamar Redskins.
Yeah, Daryl Colbert is going to get flushed out of the pocket. Inside receiver, he gets jammed as Corey Mitchell, but they just fights off, but he stayed alive on the play. Makes himself available to the quarterback. Again, coming in to the game, he's got 6 touchdown catches.
Talk about wrestling state championships. One of the young men who's having a great game for Allen. Mark is Nick Cobb. He's a 3-time state wrestling champion. One of the best in the state there, obviously.
Yeah, that's one of the things that when wrestling first started back in 98, 99, there was a lot of concern by some of our football coaches that it might cause some issues with our football programs. But I think as more people have gotten used to what's going on and exactly how things work in the wrestling world with the program that continues to grow, they're finding out that those kids really does help with agility and strength and flexibility and some of those things that are really key for football players. Those kids that are wrestlers also learn those kind of things in the wrestling room and on the mat.
Second and one now from the 25-yard line. I want to ask you about the situation next year when you look ahead to the football playoffs. There's some changes, I believe, if I'm correct, here on the 3A level, right?
There are. I mean, the legislative council passed an amendment that's going to add a 4th team to the playoffs in both conference 2A and 3A. And where that really makes a difference is in the 3A Division I bracket for football. Now that's going to be 64 teams in that bracket instead of 32, which means it is also going to be on this second weekend of championships game, which is going to make a 10-game weekend instead of a 9. Assuming the Commissioner of Education signs off on that rule proposal.
So you're still looking over a 3-day period. You would just make a couple of adjustments probably on that Thursday or Friday, right?
That probably so. I mean, we're looking at more than likely if we're going to do this. I mean, the options are obviously a couple of things. We can move it to Wednesday, which is a very difficult transition. The second opportunity would be to look at playing 4 games on Thursday.
Right.
Certainly would be an early morning for someone. But as most folks say, if it's for a state championship, just tell me when and where and I'll be there.
Yeah, if it's 6 o'clock in the morning, you know they're going to show up.
Well, and hats off to Stephenville, too. A couple weeks ago, bringing home that state championship. Just a dominating performance in the title game.
Yeah, it was great. I mean, to watch the number of points that them and El Campo put up right here in this stadium a little over a week ago, and then the next day out in Abilene with the 6-man championship games, having an opportunity there to see those guys get state championships again. 6-man football is something that just continues to thrive in Texas. We're extremely excited about the opportunities that they have to play their game at a central site out there in Abilene. And certainly, if we do get 10 games here or whatever stadium it might be next year, it's certainly going to be just another fantastic weekend for Texas high school football.
Third down and 3 now from the 34-yard line. Kyler Murray. Pass intended for Oliver Pierce. Falls incomplete. Good coverage by that secondary. And linebacking court, Gregory Gibson.
But Gregory Gibson flashed right in front of the receiver, Oliver Pierce, and almost comes up with a huge interception.
Got that hand on, as a matter of fact. Looked like left hand got a piece of it. Well, great job, as always, by the University Interscholastic League. Dr. Mark Cousins, Director of Athletics, and your staff. A lot of work for the last few days, for sure, and leading up to it.
Can't wait. Just a great opportunity for us to have a chance to watch the second half, be able to have the school administrators drape gold medals across the necks and shoulders of their football players, give a couple of more coaches state championship trophies. What a great weekend it's been. Thank you guys here at Fox Southwest for what y'all have done. It's a hard work for you guys doing three games a day for 3 days, but we appreciate what y'all have done as well.
Man, we had a lot of fun. Always good to see the state champions crowd. We appreciate the time. And you got a little more work to do tonight, don't you?
Just a little.
We're going to take a break. 5:15 to go. First half. It's a 14-8 lead for Allen. Back live, Cowboys Stadium in Arlington. 5:15 to go. First half. Allen cheerleaders enjoy themselves tonight, along with the fans of Lamar and Allen. Many of the fans from other teams stuck around, kind of taking the experience tonight too. Why not?
Well, and that's the great thing, Randy, about having it at a single site venue. I mean, you can come in here as a fan of high school football and see three games a day.
It's pretty awesome. Good stop on Ronnie Wesley. That was Cameron Hartsfield with the tackle for Allen. Check in with now with Neil Beasley. Neil.
Thanks, guys. I'm with the happiest guy in the stadium right now, Dwight Germer from Grand Prairie. And you got a truck. The State Farm Fan Up sweepstakes, and we've got us a truck winner right here. What are you thinking when it beeped on you?
I just didn't know. I mean, I first pushed the thing, and I'm like, okay. And then all of a sudden, that light, and it was like, I need a football to spike, man. This is just too good.
I'm guessing it was a wonderful Christmas present, very unexpected.
Oh, it's an unbelievable Christmas present. I can't even explain how great it is.
All right, now
I mean, it's well needed.
I remember, you know, I was asking you, all right, well, you know, you kind of live in the area, you've seen the Cowboys, and you said you're a little more familiar with this stadium than most.
Very familiar with the stadium. I was one of the architects that were on site of the stadium. So I was working with the contractor, trying to figure out things here through the course of construction. And I mean, that was a full 18 months. So, yeah, I'm pretty intimate with this stadium, and it's just a wonderful place.
And it's even better now.
Oh, it can't get any better now.
All right, now, if you guys want to get in on this Fan Up sweepstakes, you still can. Text Fan Up. They're going to give away another car, I guess, next semester. Just text Fan Up to 35350. Dwight, thanks, and congrats.
Oh, thank you very much.
All right, thank you, Neil. Appreciate that. He's a happy camper, huh? How about that? Coming to a football game, going home with a car.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that. And a stadium you're very familiar with, obviously. I'll tell you what, he said he wanted a football to spike. He didn't have that, but he did have an end zone dance.
Well done there. Ronnie Wesley. Hey, that previous play that you saw there, that interview, was the Shelby Walker catch of 20 yards from Darrell Colbert.
Morning, Jonathan Beaudoin, the 6'3", 230-pound sophomore offensive guard, was injured earlier in that series and kind of limped off, and you see him kind of limping back onto the field, but certainly looks like he's under a little bit more control. Good to see him back out there.
Yeah, he was in a lot of pain there, and they helped him off, got him checked out. Good to see him back out there. 3:45 and counting now. Second down and 6 for Lamar. Colbert looking for Bo Wells. He's got him. Now ball's loose there. Around the 35-yard line, Cameron Hartsfield with the hit. And the football down the right sideline. Finally shoved out of bounds inside the 10-yard line.
Darrell Colbert there saying, hey, the receiver was down. But Bo Wells, fighting for extra yards, gets stripped. Take a look here, Randy, out route. The catch is made. Then as he's going down on the top there of Maomi Alutu.
There's Alutu right there on Wells. Trying to finish the play here. Well, Lamar's side not happy with that call. Big break for Allen now from the 8-yard line. Kyler Murray brought down by Zelt Miner. Let's take a look at that play again here.
Well, Bo Wells makes the grab out on the sideline. Looks like he's down, but didn't see a beanbag come out either. But you got to play to the whistle. Cameron Hartsfield scoops up the strip from Alutu. Almost puts it in the end zone for a touchdown, and I think we have an injured Lamar player.
Gregory Gibson, the outside linebacker. He's a senior being attended to by the Lamar training staff. The loss of 5 yards on that play by Zell Miner on Kyler Murray. So second down and goal from the 13 when play resumes here. There's Bo Wells. A big target of Darrell Colbert so far tonight. Well, you look at Lamar's defense, Shay. Coming in 15-0, 10 of their 15 games. An amazing 10 of those 15, they've allowed 7 points or less.
Well, this is a great defense, and we're seeing it on display tonight, Randy. And quite frankly, you know, I'll call it a broken play by Kyler Murray on that first touchdown by Allen. And then the zone read run, Coach Nolan giving him an earful still. But you know, Murray's really been the difference on those two long runs. Defense has played really well. But those two long runs by Murray really the difference in the game.
Second and goal from the 13 now. Kyler Murray. He'll keep it. He's brought down by Ira Lewis. 6'2", 220-pound junior. Lewis making several big stops here in the first half for the Redskins.
Well, it's tough sledding to run it in between the tackles like that. We've seen Murray have more success when he bounces it out or gets more to the outside of that tackle box. Running in between is dangerous territory.
Third down, over the middle. Pass is caught. Kyler Murray to Cole Carter. Touchdown, Allen.
Kyler Murray puts a lot of zip on this ball. Throws it into a very tight window just beyond the outstretched arms of Derek Carmucci. Cole Carter with a sliding catch for the touchdown.
One after. Carlos Orochi is good. There's a look at Cole Carter, the junior. Big touchdown catch right over the middle. And Allen extends its lead now to 21-8 over Lamar.
Yeah, Randy, Cole Carter, son of offensive line coach Mike Carter, and his brother Tucker was a quarterback who came in and led them to the 2008 state championship game after Matt Brown went down at the beginning of the playoffs.
Yep.
And speaking of quarterbacks,
Kyler Murray.
He's had a big day so far.
Getting it done. A couple of touchdown runs himself. Take a look at some of his damage done so far tonight here at Cowboy Stadium.
Very elusive and fleet of foot as the pocket started to collapse. Made several guys miss in the backfield for the 55-yard run. Then executing the zone read to perfection. Untouched on a 68-yard touchdown romp. And locks onto his receiver, Cole Carter. And throws a dart beyond the outstretched arms of the defender.
State Farm stat of the night. Kyler Murray, 10 carries, 123 yards, 2 touchdowns on the ground. Not too shabby for the sophomore. There's Lamar now in a 13-point hole. Allen kicks it off. Brought out by Shelby Walker for the Redskins, just crossing the 20-yard line. And on the stop, Dante Meeking for the Allen Eagles. It's the key here when you got 224 or 217 to go, not to panic. You got a chance here to finish strong in this first half, go to the locker room with a little momentum and some confidence.
Yeah, a couple things. I mean, obviously for the Lamar offense is the rhythm and the continuity, and to get a little bit of flow, and they've had a difficult time doing that. There's a lot of pressure being applied by this Eagles defense. Guys coming off the edge, Christian Sam, we've seen him wreaking havoc, and Byron Bond's in there as well.
Ronnie Wesley's got some running room, turns the corner. He's knocked out of bounds by Deontay Meeking around the 35-yard line. Clock stops with 2:10 left first half.
Well, a good job of Wesley, not only picking up the first down and moving the sticks, but getting out of bounds to save a little clock there. Nice run, too, on first down.
First and 10 now for Lamar from the 35. They've got two timeouts to play with here if they need them. Well, Colbert's pass intended for Nicholas Turner. He was looking around wanting a flag, didn't get it. Turner's a junior wide receiver for the Redskins.
I like the offensive play call on first down. Take a shot downfield.
Yeah, Tom Nolan and the Redskins staff looking at a 13-point hole here, 21-8. Second down and 10 now from the 35. Colbert. A little bit of space on that right side. Crosses midfield. Into Allen territory.
Right, what a
Chad Adams chases him out.
Yeah, what a great run there by Colbert. Forced out of the pocket and had to run to his right, and he made the run decision very early, Randy. And he got some fantastic blocks downfield. Not a design run. Man coverage by the Allen defense, and once they see the quarterback running, nice job of sealing off and walling off those Eagle defenders. And Allen wanting to use one of their timeouts here.
Yeah, they got all three, so they've got two left, as does Lamar. Minute 50 to go here, so the Redskins have pushed it out to the 40-yard line of the Allen Eagles.
Three snaps, moving the ball across the midfield stripe. So you're going to want to find out if you're the Allen Eagles where number 44 is. Corey Mitchell on third and 23, Randy. 41-yard catch and run.
Yep.
By Mitchell to get into the end zone for the Redskins touchdown.
Held off to it, took it home. Minute 50 left first half, but at halftime, we got a lot of action coming your way. We'll take you back to the studio, check in with Rick Renner and recruiting guru Randy Rogers coming up on the Ford Halftime Show. We'll also recap all of the Texas State Championship action. A lot of highlights to go through over the last couple of days and throughout a busy Saturday here at Cowboys Stadium. Of course, this is the ninth and final game over 3 days. A lot of fun since the action got underway at noon on Thursday. All right, first down for the Redskins. Colbert over the middle. He finds Corey Mitchell again. Mitchell takes a big lick there around the 22 and holds on to the football.
Well, playing halves in the secondary, and that's the soft spot in the middle of the field. And Corey Mitchell is the inside receiver.
Big hit by Cameron Hartsfield.
He takes a big shot, but he does a fantastic job of running the route and hanging on to the ball.
18 yards on that pass play from Colbert to Corey Mitchell. Gets it down now to the 22-yard line for the Redskins. Colbert again looking for Shelby Walker. Wanted the flag.
He got two.
Michael Jacob, he's got it. Michael Jacob on the coverage there, the senior, number 24.
Well, Shelby Walker had man coverage, Randy, and he has that outside release. Darrell Colbert threw more like a little bit of a jump ball or a go-get-it type of a ball. And Shelby Walker made a play on it. Michael Jacob ran him over and drew the flag.
Officials talk it over here. Minute 17 to go. Lamar looking for a big break here to try to get back in this football game. And Lamar's side, Darrell Culver clapping. Obviously, it's going to be against the Allen Eagles.
There were multiple fouls on the play. Personal foul, defense. That penalty will be declined. Defensive pass interference on the defense. It's a 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Here's a play again. Pass intended for Shelby Walker. I think Michael Jacob knew it. So if you're Lamar now, Shay, you got a minute 17 to try to take care of business and get back in this thing.
And you still have two timeouts. I don't think there's going to be any concerted effort by this Redskins offense to run the clock, but pretty much they don't have to change anything in their offense right now, Randy. Plenty of time left in good field position.
Here's Colbert up the middle. He's got a seam. There's Colbert in for the Lamar touchdown.
Well, Culver with the pump fake. Again, he knows that he has man coverage. Take a look here, the pump fake. Design play from the get-go. Turns it up and runs it right in the end zone, Randy. He goes in untouched. Ninth rushing touchdown on the year for Darrell Culver.
Big boost for this Redskin football team. Point after coming up from Alan Melgar. Kick is up and good by Melgar. And with 1:12 to go first half, six-play drive, goes 80 yards. And Lamar gets it done in just over a minute, minute five. Pass interference call. Help him down the stretch. Get him a little bit closer there. Ninth rushing touchdown, as you mentioned, for Colby. And now it's a 21-15 lead for Allen.
A good job, really, by this Redskins team, ready to get back into the game. A lot of momentum seemingly on the Allen sideline after the strip ball fumble and return by Hartsfield. They got the ball all the way down near the goal line, and then they punch it in for the touchdown, or excuse me, the catch by Cole Carter for the touchdown. But Lamar Redskins, like they have done all year, respond with a touchdown of their own and little battle of momentum going on right now between
really
these two teams.
If you're Allen, going to try to get some good field position. You got a little over a minute to work with here to try to march it down. Jan Adams and Maiomi Olatu back for the Allen Eagles, number four, number five.
And Olatu, Randy, is a very dangerous return man. He opened the third quarter last week in the state semifinal game against DeSoto with a kickoff return for touchdown. So you had two home run hitters back there in Adams and Olatu.
Alan Melgar will kick it off for Lamar. And this will go back to Chad Adams. They'll take it at the 12-yard line. Here comes Adams. Special teams effort for Lamar, excellent. From the 15-16 yard line, they converge on Chad Adams.
Nice job by Glenn Anderson on special teams, the junior linebacker. Backup linebacker getting a little bit of playing time on special teams, comes up with a nice tackle.
Well, we've seen it twice already tonight, Shay, from Kyler Murray. Doesn't take long, 55-yarder. 68-yarder. They can strike in a hurry here. The Lamar defense has to be careful. Handoff there to Marcus Ward up the middle. Crossing the 20. And stop made by Aaron Mitchell of Lamar, middle linebacker. Our fans on their feet looking for a stop. Second and six. Pressure on Kyler Murray. And down he goes. It's Zeltmeyer again.
Well, Zeltmeyer is just such a force off the edge, Randy. He is getting blocked He fights through the block, and as Murray steps up in the pocket, moves to his left. You'll take a look at big number 92 right here. Closing down and fighting off a blocker with the left arm, sweeping the right arm right over the top.
Lamar, second charge, timeout of the half.
All right, on third and 12, Lamar will take another timeout. They're down to one left here in the first half. Still two for Allen.
Yeah, that's a good timeout right there. Because right now you've got an opportunity to force a punt if you hold here on third down.
As soon as we get attendance figures later in this football game, we'll pass it along. I'm anxious to see what the final number is here. This is a nice crowd.
I want to see somebody from the UIL going around counting one by one.
That's
though.
What I want to see, too. I want the exact figure.
Pretty stealth comment by Dr. Cousins, though. We're going to count them one by one, make sure we got it right. And we're going to wait a little bit later.
Some late arrivals. Very smart. Well, I'm comparing it to what it was a couple of years ago when we had that crowd of, 48,000, I believe, for that Pearland-Trinity game, right?
I think that's right.
And this resembles that, if not more. My memory serves me correctly here.
All right. Big third down play.
Third down at 12 now. Allen back on its own 16-yard line. 30 seconds left here in the first half. Tyler Murray chased out of the pocket. And down he goes at the 11-yard line. That's Kyron Mitchell.
What great pressure by that defense. Ira Lewis forcing Murray out of the pocket.
Timeout. Lamar, their final timeout of the half.
And Mitchell able to do the cleanup here, but Kyler Murray looking downfield. Got big Ira Lewis kind of barreling in on you. Zelt Minor, of course, he's always around the ball, too, but defensive front for Lamar, it's like they turned it on in this series.
Couple big stops, but they needed it most because, hey, with a minute, well, they have about a minute 12, I think, when this drive started. That's plenty of time for this Allen offense. They need some stops, and the Redskins have delivered so far on this drive.
Now, a couple of negative, back-to-back negative plays. Puts it into a fourth and 17. Ball is sitting at the 11-yard line. So that means this punt will come from the end zone of the Allen Eagles. We'll talk about the prowess of Zelt Minor. He also has two block on top of everything else that he's done defensively. Two block punts on the season.
Shane Tapuka back to punt for Allen. And back around midfield for Lamar is Dejon Druitt. Tapuka will get the punt off. Druitt will let it bounce at midfield. Pretty good bounce.
And
the Eagles down inside the 40-yard line.
Keep letting it roll. Don't touch it. Don't touch it.
Right at the 40.
That's Coach Westerberg saying that. Obviously, right?
Great punt by Tapuka there.
Yeah, you could have saved maybe about 5 or 6 seconds had Lamar Returman been able to go up and field the punt on a fair catch, but it came out a little bit squirrely. Druitt decided not to try to field it.
We got 8 seconds left. You're down on your own 40. Do you go ahead and go after it here? Give it a shot with 8 seconds left?
Let's take a look at what the Allen Eagle defense is doing right now if you want to take a shot.
Not much.
I'm counting
everybody
two,
downfield.
Four, six. There are eight guys that are nowhere near the line of scrimmage, Randy.
Yep. Yeah, if Lamar could pull this off. Yeah, he'll just take a knee. Darrell Coleman. And it'll go down to zeros here in the first half. The Lamar Redskins. 7-yard quarterback keeper by Darrell Colbert keeps things tight 21-15. as we go to the break. Check in now with Jim Knox. Jim.
All right, thank you, Randy. Coach, I tell you what, Lamar scored late here in the first half, got a little momentum going, and what are you going to tell your team at halftime here?
Well, we got to settle down a little bit, got to get Kyler settled down a little bit, and then we have to make a few corrections, and we'll come out and play a great second half.
Talk about Kyler Murray. How are you going to settle him down?
Well, he's fine in the run game. We just got to settle him down, throw him the football a little bit, and we'll make some good adjustments in there and come back and play a good second half.
Thank you, Coach. Randy?
All right, thank you, Jim. Appreciate it. Halftime break underway here at Cowboys Stadium. Now the Eagles make their way in. Here's Darrell Colbert. That touchdown to make a 21-15 lead. As we go to break, special message from your Texas 49ers. Back live, Cowboys Stadium here in Arlington, getting ready for the second half. Allen leading the Lamar Redskins 21-15 here at Cowboys Stadium. Randy McAvoy, Shea Walker with you. Interesting first half. It could go either way here in the second half. Lamar with that late touchdown's back in and out.
Well, interesting and exciting. I mean, we've seen good play by both teams, Randy. We've seen momentum shifts and swings, and we're talking about a six-point game right now.
Let's take a look at some of the highlights, if we can, from the first half. And plenty to show you. Let's begin with Kyler Murray. Really put on a show here in the first half for the Allen Eagles.
Well, an exceptional job of avoiding the rush, and really a broken play for Kyler Murray, and goes in for a 55-yard touchdown rate. The next time he touches the ball, executes the zone read to perfection. He goes 68 yards untouched for Allen's second touchdown. And then a nice job of locating Cole Carter, his wide receiver, throws it into a very tight window for the touchdown. Nice first half by Kyler Murray.
And for Lamar, Darrell Colbert. Completion out there to Bo Wells in the turnover there.
Yeah, and Nalutu comes up with that strip, and that really gave the Allen defense a little shot in the leg. And Colbert late, Randy, in the second quarter, comes up with a touchdown to tighten this game up.
A lot of momentum going into the locker room. You look at the score, 21-15. So if you're Lamar, you got to feel pretty good about things as you start quarter number three here at Cowboys Stadium. Let's take a look at some of the stats now from the first half between Lamar, brought to you by Ford. Overall total yards, 225 for Lamar, 165 for Allen.
Well, you think about the way that it's unfolded there. You see those six penalties for 55 yards and the turnover, and really that is the difference in the game.
All right, let's check in with the head coach of Lamar. That would be Tom Nolan. Neil Beasley is with him right now. Neil.
All right, thank you so much, Randy. Coach, you're down, but only six. What did you talk about most at halftime there?
Well, the big thing we got to do is get the ball to bounce our way a little bit, and we got to stop number one. He's made two huge plays on us, so we got to stop. If we can stop him, we got a good chance to win the game.
Yeah, is there something specific you can do to get that guy?
Well, no, we just, you know, we got to play assignment football and just watch him on every play.
Which is what you've been doing pretty much all year, so I'm guessing just do what you do and do it well, right?
That's right. Do what we do and do it well.
All right, good luck second half. Thank you, Coach.
All right, thank you very much, Neil Beasley. Appreciate that. Time of possession in the first half. Lamar had it, Shea, for 14:47, 9 minutes, 13 seconds for Allen. So they trail, but they have a possession with that category.
Well, the defensive stop, we go back to that again, Randy, and Miami Alutu strips the ball, and it looks like Bo Wells is down on the ground, but the strip comes. Cameron Hartsfield, who is always around the ball, making big plays for Allen's secondary, comes up with the fumble recovery, and he brings the ball all the way down to the 4-yard line, and really that in fact is the difference in the ball game.
So Allen will kick it off here, back to receive Nicholas Turner, number 6 for Lamar. Also Cedric Lancaster back around the 15-yard line. That'll be the short kick, but Lancaster will field it around the 25-yard line. Lancaster will bring it out, crosses the 30-yard line, down to 32. So here come the Redskins to start the third quarter. 5A Division I state championship. 21-15 lead for Allen. There's Darrell Colbert. Getting that big touchdown. Got him back in it late in the first half.
Well, that Redskins defense performed well when they needed to, and you think about the big plays in this game. Kyler Murray breaks down the defense with an exceptional scramble on that 55-yard touchdown run. And then the next play, He just caught the Lamar defense out of the right spot and comes up big, but
first and 10 from the 32-yard line. That's Ronnie Wesley. Nice yardage around that right side, brought down by Cameron Hartsfield. Ronnie Wesley's had a pretty good ball game so far tonight.
Well, he is the leading rusher on this team that has rushed for over 2,400 yards. 922 coming into the game, and nice job of following his blocker there by Corey Mitchell.
Hand off again to Wesley. And he's met right there by Marcus Davis, 5'9", 236-pound junior, making this first stop tonight. He's up second down and 10 now. They'll mark it at the 47-yard line. Mulbert feeling the pressure. That was Chad Adams bringing a heat there on Darrell Colbert. Just in time, Colbert got the throw off.
We talked about this early in the first half. But Corey Kane, defensive coordinator, likes to bring pressure off the edge. Chad Adams, a strong safety, coming in on the backside as Colbert was looking out to his left. Gets drilled trying to get the ball out to Bo Wells, but Chad Adams closing in on him. And again, this is an extremely fast secondary for Allen.
Third down and 10 now for Lamar. Lamar side on their feet. Allen side making a little noise here, wanting a defensive stop to open this second half. Lancaster in motion. Colbert in trouble. Backtracking. Tries to throw it away. He does. Pressure there from Tay Evans. Tell you what, he just didn't have much time at all.
Well, he didn't have much time, and every time he gave up ground, Randy, Tay Evans kept increasing on him. There is a late flag.
Yeah, back there about the 23-yard line, about where Colbert released the football.
Not sure if he got the ball to the line of scrimmage, and that most likely is what the flag is, but
additional grounding on the offense. The ball did not reach the neutral zone. Fourth down. That's a loss of down.
Wow, that's big. That really pretty much negates the run by Ronnie Wesley. From a field position standpoint, when you see Oliver Pierce, Randy, standing at the 40, his own 46-yard line.
And Oliver Pierce, he'll field the punt from Bradley and Cincy. Cincy back at his own 13-yard line. So good field position most likely here for Allen.
Well, Pierce with the fair catch, and that was the first time that we've seen Piercy do the conventional punt. For the punts that he kicked in the first half, Randy, he was doing that little rugby style,
right,
trying to get the roll. And he did so pretty well, and did a nice job getting some good air underneath that one, forcing Pierce to signal for the fair catch.
There's Kyler Murray, 112 rushing yards tonight, 38 through the air, 3 touchdowns. Again, he had that 68 and 55 yarder, also a touchdown pass to the second quarter for the Eagles.
Here, Coach Westenberg tell Jim Knox when he was going into the half, they want to settle Murray down just a little bit, and nice little safe pass out to Oliver Pierce. Kind of get into a little bit of a rhythm there for Murray.
Here's a pretty good little weapon there.
Marcus Ward is just such a tough runner. 5'7", 165 pounds. He takes a shot behind the line of scrimmage, Randy. Take a look here. But he doesn't go down. And finishes off the run. He didn't pick up many yards, but
tough,
he finished it off in a strong way.
Well, that whistle blows. He keeps moving, doesn't he? Third down and 4 now for the 47 for Allen. Allen Murray waiting for the play to be signaled in and ready to go here. 3rd and 4. There's Murray. Pass is caught. It's Oliver Pierce again. Coverage on the play from John Bonney. Oliver Pierce, an all-purpose guy, opened the season, actually is the starting quarterback before Kyler Murray stepped in.
Well, he did start at quarterback, but he is also wide receiver, also runs the ball some. Very valuable asset for this Allen team. Remember we talked about Nick Cobb, the three-time state champ in wrestling for the Allen Eagles. Well, Oliver Pierce, he's an All-America wrestler. He's going to Oklahoma on a wrestling scholarship.
Yeah, right now weighs 167, but he drops weight to compete in the class he's in there. That competition begins. He was a wide receiver last couple of years after losing some competition to Alec Morris, who went on to Alabama. He's one of those guys that just wants to step up and help any way he can. And they definitely have a spot for Oliver Pierce in this lineup.
We'll look for him again here in the slot. Last time on third and about 4 or 5, which it is right now, he ran the little quick out route.
They're down at 4 for the 41-yard line. Keep an eye on that 37. That's where they need to get to move these chains here. Here's Murray. Pass intended again for Oliver Pierce. Good coverage from John Bonney. That one's incomplete.
On the coverage by Bonney. Looks like it's a good throw here by Murray. Reading Pierce, just not able to come down to this because Bonney closes in on him and grabs that right arm, rakes it back, puts the ball on the carpet. This Redskins defense, when it has to make plays, it makes plays. Right, there's a flag down.
Bonney, fair catch is made around the 9. Yeah, flag is down back at the around the 44-yard line.
Well, and both side judges threw the flag. It's 4th down and 4. And if this Markoff goes against Lamar, it'll be a 1st down.
Illegal formation, more than five men in the backfield, the 5-yard penalty, re-kick.
We'll reconvene here, re-kick it. There's a flag flying right there, immediately saw it.
The Lancaster fair caught the ball, Randy, on the 10-yard line, and we'll see if the Redskins are able to improve on that field position.
Better Lancaster now back for Lamar. That one lands around the 12-yard line, and he'll grab it there at the 14. So Lamar will get it back after the Chantapuka punt. Here come the Redskins with 8:15 to go in the third quarter. Get a attendance total at some point here in the third, maybe fourth quarter for you.
Timeout.
Great turnout for 3 days here at Cowboys Stadium. We'll take a timeout. 8:15 to play. 21-15 Allen leading Lamar.
Why is it?
In this drive on their own 14-yard line, Darrell Colburn and the Redskins. A chip away at this deficit against Allen. Colbert, nothing up the middle. He's going to be squeezed out, but somehow gets loose. He's got a little running room. Colbert at midfield. Open space in front of him at the 40. Inside the 20. It brought down near the 15-yard line. Darrell Colbert. Cameron Hartsfield with the stop for Allen. Pick up of 67 yards.
Well, I would think Darrell Colbert has eyes in the back of his head because Chad Adams, number 5, seemingly, Randy, twice in that long zigzagging, swerving run by Colbert. Looked like Chad Adams, number 5, was going to catch him. Colbert kept bobbing and weaving and moving around, though. Just an outstanding run. Hartsfield finally comes up with the tackle.
Lamar fans on their feet here. First and 10 from the 17. Handoff to Ronnie Wesley. Brought down by Christian Sand. Numbers tonight for Darrell Colbert, 133 yards rushing, 115 through the air, two total touchdowns. Big night for the junior quarterback for the Redskins.
Well, how about both quarterbacks for these teams, Randy, making huge plays in the scramble game.
Second down and 8 now from the 15-yard line. Colbert, more room at the 10-yard line, runs over the official, the umpire. Christian Sam will bring it down. The umpire took a big hit.
Well, he was, the umpire was trying to get out of the way. Colbert making the decision early to run the ball. Another good job, Randy, right there. Ooh, he's got to protect the ball. You see that ball hanging out there a little bit? Oh,
gotta,
no.
You got to tuck that thing, don't you?
Secure the rock.
Yeah, the umpire was backpedaling, trying to get out of the way. Yeah, Darrell Colbert coming at you. There he is. Back up on his feet. Time to keep working here.
I think had the collision with the umpire not have happened, that might have been a first down, but it's third and about 2 yards.
That was Jim Giro, the umpire. Took a hit, but stayed in there. That's Tay Evans on the coverage.
Tay Evans, a very physical linebacker. You see Colbert's helmet ratcheted up.
Oh, big hit on Colbert there.
Yep, Tay Evans, 6'3", 197-pound junior. Darrell Colbert looks like he needs a break.
Pretty big hit there. Yeah, he's been jarred a couple of times tonight.
There's obviously going to be a timeout. There's only 10 seconds on the play clock. And he's nowhere near the huddle, nor were the Redskins anywhere near the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, a little cut there on his face.
Lamar, first charge timeout of the half.
It's 6:13 to go, third quarter. We'll break with them. 21-15. Allen leading Lamar. Redskins trying to punch it in.
No one's ever going to touch American Idol.
It's 13 to go. Fourth down play coming up for the Lamar Redskins. Ready, fourth and one on the 8-yard line.
Spread the formations, trips to the top of the screen.
Colbert will keep. Stop is made by Nick Cobb, and he's going to be short of the first down.
Running the option play away from the three receiver set. You see it coming down the right-hand side of your screen. You see Darrell Colbert decides to keep the ball instead of pitching it out, and Tay Evans around the legs, Nick Cobb around the upper part of the body, and Darrell Colbert not able to muscle through for the first down.
Missed opportunity for Lamar, threatening deep in Eagle territory, but they give it back now, downs. And Allen will take over, first and 10 from their own 8-yard line. That's Marcus Ward with the carry, crossing the 10. It's up 4 yards on the play. Gregory Gibson on the stop, number 42 for Lamar.
Well, it's nice to see Gibson back in the game. He was the injured linebacker for this Redskins team in the first half, and nice job of him closing down and getting inside the block of Cade Camp.
Tyler Murray out to Oliver Pierce. John Bonney on the coverage for the Redskins.
Oliver Pierce.
Yeah, they're trying to, nice little connection starting to heat up a little
bit.
Yeah,
167 pounds, but you see him take that shot by John Bonney, but maybe a little bit of that wrestling prowess and balance and strength to fight through that tackle and pick up yards. Should have been a negative play. He actually picks up about 2 yards.
Third down and four for the Eagles from the 14. Pressure on Murray, gets the pass off. Coverage by Cedric Lancaster. Pass intended for Cameron Calcote.
An outstanding play by Lancaster. We talked about young man headed for to SMU. Comes over with the right hand. Take a look. Murray locks onto the receiver. Lancaster's left arm around the back of Cameron Calcote, but not touching. Swiping down with that right hand to make sure it's an incomplete pass.
Dejon Druitt and Cedric Lancaster, who just made that play, back to receive this punt. Shane Trapuka, they're around midfield. Nice punt by Trapuka. Fair catch is called for around the 46-yard line. So Redskins get it back in Eagle territory. Let's toss it down to the sidelines. Check in with Neil Beasley.
Hey, guys, yeah, Darryl Colbert, remember, took that huge shot in the last series, second to last play of that series. He was bleeding from his chin, but really that's all just it, as he was sitting over here, had a towel on there trying to wipe off the blood. But I don't think it's any kind of injury. Hey, you just got to bleed a little when you're going for a state title, but he's obviously back in there in his 29th straight start.
Yeah, he's been running the show since his sophomore season. Some kind of a great run there for Colbert. A lot of experience early on. Big senior season ahead next year.
Well, very durable. 13 games as a sophomore, starting his 16th game, 29th in a row.
First and 10 now for the 46-yard line. Ronnie Wesley in trouble. Has to go right side. Little help from Darryl Colbert. Tackle made by Ryan Johnson. Saw nothing on the left side, so just made a beeline. Try to get something out of it.
Well, the defensive pressure up front is just outstanding by this Allen's defense. I mean, I tell you what, that's a lot of work for 3-yard gain. Ronnie Wesley running hard. He runs up the back of his quarterback there.
15 carries, 69 yards, averaging 4.6 a carry tonight. Ronnie Wesley. Second down and 7 for the 43. Wesley again.
Draw play there, and that was a nice fake there by Darryl Colbert looking downfield. Following the block of Corey Mitchell there.
Initial contact by Nick Cobb. Byron Bonds.
This Allen defense has just been outstanding all season long. The lone loss to Capel in week 5. Big third down here for Lamar offense.
37 for the 43. See a false start penalty against Lamar.
Fourth snap, false start on the offense, 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
Nick Cobb, the Bandit linebacker in his defense for the Eagles. 7 tackles tonight. A heck of a ball game. Little standouts. This Allen D tonight against Lamar.
So 3rd and 7 just went to 3rd and 12. Let's see what the Redskins have.
Earl Colbert looking for the deep ball. Nothing there. We got a flag down though. Intended receiver Shelby Walker. Michael Jacob on the coverage. He was flagged earlier in the game for interference. We'll see who it's on here.
Pass interference on the defense. 15 yards.
Well, Shelby Walker, who has got burner speed, Michael Jacob just walls him off. I'm standing in front of him, so I guess that's impeding the route there, and drew the flags.
Michael Jacob, 5'11", 160-pound senior. Started his high school career at Boyd High School. He was a Boyd Bronco before transferring into the Allen Eagle program. First and 10 now from the 33-yard line for the Redskins. Colbert looking there for Corey Mitchell. A little bit off the mark. Ball's incomplete.
Well, Randy, those are the types of plays that this Redskins team need to make. Corey Mitchell was open in the flat, lined up in the backfield, did a nice job of releasing out, knowing that he's going to have one-on-one coverage by one of the linebackers. It was Christian Sam, but not able to come up with the catch off the pass by Colbert.
Second down and 10 now for the Redskins. It's up and going here. 21-15 deficit against Allen. There's Colbert chased out. Finds a little seam. Knocked down just shy of the 20-yard line by Chad Adams.
Randy, Darrell Colbert knows that he's going to take a shot at the end of this run. Take a look. And he makes the decision to run early. And he has enough speed to bust it up through. And he knows he's going to take a shot. Continues to run down that line and trying to pick up as many yards as he can, and it's enough to move the chains for a first down.
Big conversion for the Redskins. .248 left, third quarter here tonight. Handoff, Ronnie Wesley. Out of the 18. 3-yard pickup brought down by Cameron Hartsfield.
Well, Hartsfield's going to get the tackle, but the play was made by Christian Sam, the linebacker, who forced Ronnie Wesley to cut it back to the inside.
He's looking for the end zone. That's Bo Wells, and that's a Redskins touchdown.
That's some nifty ball handling, Randy, by Darrell Colbert. Almost looks nonchalant as he makes that play fake. He just kind of stands there and goes dead. Bo Wells streaking across the middle, lines up on the left side, never breaks stride. Outraces Alutu. Coverage wasn't bad, but the throw and the catch were fantastic.
Bo Wells goes there for it and holds on to a nice catch. Point after a tip by Alan Melgar is no good. And we're tied at 21.
Take a look at Darrell Colbert, Randy, and how nonchalant, well, we'll catch it here in a second, but locks on to his receivers. He's rolling out to the right. Wells comes all the way from the left side of the screen. Again, Tay Evans in the face of Colbert. But Colbert delivers a strike. But Wells comes up with a great grab for the touchdown.
A little reaction there from Darrell Colbert. Six-play drive, 46 yards, 2:23 off the clock. 18-yard touchdown. Darrell Colbert to Bo Wells. Ball game here tonight, don't
you? Yeah, this Lamar team hanging around, doing what they need to do. Six play, 46-yard drive, 2 minutes 23 off the clock, and not exactly how you would draw it up, but certainly good enough. Pass interference penalty certainly helped on that drive. Taking advantage of the opportunities, and again, Darrell Colbert doing a masterful job of evading that Allen rush and that Allen pressure. Rolling out, throws a perfect strike on the run to Bo Wells.
Oliver Pierce will bring it out for Allen. He's got a seam, shakes a tackle at the 30. Here comes Oliver Pierce, turns the corner, inside the 40. Takes a hit, keeps going inside the 20, down to the 15-yard line.
Well, when you need a big play, you go to your senior leader, the guy who does everything for this Eagles team, Randy. As a quarterback, running back, defensive back, does it all. Punt returner. And then what a great kickoff return to put the Eagles in an outstanding field position. See if they can answer that score.
82-yard kickoff return. Kyler Murray on the keeper. John Boddy with the stop. Let's take a look at it again towards the end of his kickoff return. Look at the focus from Oliver Pierce here.
Well, he's patient. He almost comes to a complete stop. Lets a couple of tacklers go by him, and just the strength to stay on his feet, hang on to the ball, starts it back up again, and carries a few more tacklers forward.
Second down and three, Kyler Murray. He's looking for Oliver Pierce again.
Ooh, and the coverage was good. Well, that's one that Coach Westerberg and Jeff Fleener, offensive coordinator, going, oh, wait a minute.
Who's that got a hand on it? Was that like Cedric Lancaster got a hand on it? John Bonney also there for Lamar.
Well, here's this Redskins defense again. On first down, this Allen offense gains about 7 yards. Holding an incomplete pass on second down. Kind of doing what they do. It's like yeoman-like work for them as well up front.
Marcus Ward.
What a tough run by Marcus Ward. He's been bottled up ever since the first quarter. He is so physical. Not a big guy, but man, what a tough runner he is. 5'7", 165 pounds, and he runs like he's 200.
Kyler Murray down to the 1 yard line for Allen. Under a minute to play here, third quarter.
The Allen offense lining up, no huddle, getting the call from Murray, the big offensive line. Scrimmaging from the 1 yard line on second down.
Hand off, Marcus Ward, touchdown Eagles.
Well, John Bonney got sideswiped there and he's down. Just got up. Marcus Ward, though, bounces it outside. Woo. John Bonney, that right lower area of the leg, down in the ankle. Fantastic to see him back up.
Carlos Orochi in for the extra point, up and good. So Allen quickly answers back after the Lamar touchdown that tied this football game, and the Eagles are back up. 28-21, 16th rushing touchdown this season for Marcus Ward.
You know, Randy, we've not really seen the Allen offense put together, I'll just call it a traditional methodical drive. But man, when they hit the big play, home run hitters, Oliver Pierce doing a great job on that kickoff return, but Kyler Murray obviously with the two long touchdown runs, the defensive turnover that put him down on the goal line in scoring position, and now that Redskins offense, see if they can answer.
26 seconds left, third quarter. Cedric Lancaster back, along with Nicholas Turner this time for Lamar. There's Turner. They're both around the 15-yard line. And a kickoff coming up from Carlos Orochi. Their catch is made by Corey Mitchell of the Redskins. So back-to-back touchdowns from Lamar. Now Allen. Let's see if the Redskins can respond here to end the third quarter. Nolan talking it over with Darrell Colbert. There's Marcus Ward on the sidelines. Getting the congratulatory high fives from everybody. First and 10 now from the 23 for the Redskins. There's Colbert in trouble. Down he goes on the 15-yard line. Jack Hawkins and Nick Cobb for Allen. Also a little help from Lance Williams as well.
Nick Cobb is the first guy to run past Darrell Colbert. And Colbert makes him miss. Take a look right here at number 31. Closes down. Colbert makes him miss, but as he tries to go forward, Cobb slows down, turns back around, and is able to bring Colbert down for a loss.
Quarter number three is in the books. A little bit for both teams. Allen has reclaimed the lead, 28-21. We've got 12 minutes to go here at Cowboys Stadium. As we go to break, a special message from DQ.
We hope you're...
in drive one. Fans having a good time tonight here in Arlington. The finale, ninth state championship game over a three-day period. Great crowds throughout from the start on Thursday at noon until the nightcap tonight. Got 12 minutes left in the 5A Division I state championship. Allen leading Lamar 28-21. Second and 17 for the Redskins as we pick it up and open the fourth and final quarter. Second and 17 now from the 16. Colbert on the run. Pressure coming. Pass intended for Cedric Lancaster. Anthony Walker and Tay Evans on the coverage. Bringing the heat for the Eagles. Check in now with Jim Knox on the Allen sideline.
All right, Randy, I tell you what, there's some blows dished out here tonight. Look at Marcus Ward, just scored the touchdown, then also taking some shots tonight. His left arm, they just bandaged that up. He's going to be all right. Then to the left, Kyler Murray sitting there by himself, just trying to take it all in, trying to get his breath. These guys are playing their hearts out. This is a good one.
Yes, indeed. Big fourth quarter ahead here at Cowboys Stadium.
Thanks, Jim.
Third down at 17 now from the 16-yard line. Colbert, plenty of time to throw, finally chased out. He's on the run. Pass falls incomplete. It was intended for Dejon Druett. Kind of an off-balance throw from Darrell Colbert there on the run.
That's one of the most difficult throws for a quarterback to make, running to your left. I'm not going to say rolling because he was running for his life, getting pressure for that Allen defense. Druett not able to come up with the grab. You know, Randy, Oliver Pierce was in this entire defensive series for Allen, and now he goes back to field the punt.
Timeout. Timeout. Allen, first charge timeout of the half.
All right, Allen takes the timeout. They've got two left in the game. Not sure what that's about. Coaching staff may have seen something they didn't like. Want to talk it over. Allen cheerleaders having fun tonight. Oliver Pierce. He really has done it all. All the folks here at Cowboys Stadium making our air and, of course, making the big screen. That's a, they go crazy when they see themselves on that big screen out there.
Well, that is awfully accurate and an awfully big screen. Heck, you'd be doing that if we saw you on the screen, Randy.
All kinds of moves for you.
Yeah, I'm telling you, I'm almost, look out. All right.
That'll get you some screen time, won't it?
Yeah. All right. One for all here. State championships Saturday.
Bradley and Cincy will punt it away for Lamar. Oliver Pierce back for Allen. Right now he's at Lamar's 44-yard line. So important to get intensity to get this kick off and get a good one. Nearly blocked. If they get a good bounce, actually they do inside the 50. And they'll mark it at the 49-yard line. But Bradley and Cincy gets that punt off, and Allen will get it back on offense, leading by a touchdown.
Well, Cameron Hartsfield, Randy, number 21. Take a look at him off the edge. He almost blocks it. I mean, he missed that by a fingernail. He has 6 blocked punts on the season. Almost had his 7th. But he was in the right spot. It looked like he almost overran it.
He knows it, too. You can see him on the sideline.
He knew it was close. Yeah,
that was very close. Allen gets it back now. Excellent field position for their own 49-yard line. 1st and 10. Kyler Murray will keep it. Crosses the 50. Brought down on the play by Gregory Gibson of Lamar. Flag down back a little further down near the 32-yard line. Of the Redskins. Tyler Crew on the call tonight here in the 5A Division I state championship.
Face mask on the offense, 15-yard penalty, remains first down.
Well, and Coach Westerberg is like going, come on. Get a face mask on the offense on a running play, but they did. Officials correctly threw the flag and negates a decent run there on first down by Kyler Murray.
1st and 20 now. They'll push it back after that penalty back on the 39-yard line. Hand off there to Marcus Ward. He's brought down again by Gregory Gibson. One of 2 seniors in this linebacking corps.
Well, you hear the pads popping, Randy. Kyler Murray on the keeper there.
Dariel Smith is checked in, senior defensive back. Down at 10 now for the 49. Redskins defense looking for the stop. Just over 10 minutes to play. Murray will throw it away. Flag down again around the 44-yard line.
An impressive rush there by Ira Lewis. Collapsing the pocket. You see there, holding call. Against the Eagles.
Holding on the offense. That penalty will be declined. 4th down.
A couple of big penalties here on this drive against Allen. Here's the latest one. Here's the holding call right there.
Yeah, it's on Ira Lewis. Said just crashing through the pocket. 6'2", 220 pounds of mean at you.
Well, take a look at this crowd. Final attendance total is in 48,379 for the 5A Division I state championship. What a great turnout. And a great day, final day here at Cowboys Stadium in Arlington. Lancaster. Fair catch is made around the 16-yard line. A little back and forth so far in this 4th quarter.
The Redskins defense really holding this Allen offense, Randy, down, other than that 1 long kickoff return by Oliver Pierce. It's been pretty tough going for the Eagles offense.
TV timeout.
Sounds like we're going to timeout.
We'll take a timeout, too, with them. 9:52 to go, 4th quarter, tight ball game. Allen leading Lamar 28-21. We're coming right back. Redskins will get it back. Their own 16-yard line. Got a touchdown. Now the coaching staff giving final instructions. They take it out on the field. Bo Wells, senior wide receiver, had that great touchdown catch for the Redskins. Lamar looking for some more magic here in the final quarter. A lot of football left here. They're looking to get on their own 16-yard line. First and 10 for Lamar. Ronnie Wesley. As you see, he'll take it. Out near the 30, brought down at the 28 by Byron Bonds.
We've seen the Redskins offense do this on first down, picking up about 12 yards. Did Wesley. It'll move the chains, and now it's the continuity. A lot easier said than done. This is a very aggressive Allen defense, but you want to get a little bit of continuity so you can't string together a couple of first downs, change the field position a little bit.
18 carries tonight for Ronnie Wesley, 86 yards for the Redskins sophomore running back. If Wesley again, he'll add to that total. Out near midfield to the 47-yard line before he's hauled down by Chad Adams. That's a pickup of 17, so he's over 100 yards for the night.
Kind of what we're talking about is getting that little running game going, and nice job of finishing that run, lowering the shoulder. With two plays, you said this, they started off on their 16-yard line. They're now at midfield on successive running plays there by Ronnie Wesley, who just went over the 100-yard mark.
Yeah, he's a sophomore. Darrell Colbert's a junior. Shelby Walker, one of the receivers, only a junior. Young offensive line. Well, these guys are coming back. Flag is down on the play around the 46-yard line
offside,
or so.
On the defense. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Against the defense, against Allen.
You talk about Ronnie Wesley, the sophomore. He started out number 3 on the depth chart at the beginning of the season. Has worked himself up into the starting role, and boy, the future is awfully bright.
Really is. Yeah, left front, you got a sophomore, junior on that offensive line. Just one senior. Very young Redskins team here on offense. And 5 now for the 48-yard line. Hand off to Shelby Walker. He'll flip it to Bo Wells. Back out to Darrell Colbert. He's got it at the 40. And down he goes at the 35. Little trickery for the Redskins.
Well, Chad Adams was in perfect position. He played it perfectly, stayed at home, read his keys, just couldn't stop the completion here. You see the speed sweep, you see the toss, and then Darrell Colbert rolling out to the right. Bo Wells heaves it down there, and what a great play by Colbert to come back to the ball, make the catch.
First and 10 from the 35-yard line now for the Redskins. Ronnie Wesley, this slip and down he goes at the 38. Christian Sam with the stop for Allen.
The leverage that this Allen team plays with, Randy, is very impressive. A first down running play, and the inside pressure from Christian Sam, number 2, forces Wesley to the outside. But you'll see number 21, Cameron Hartsfield, coming up. Nick Cobb there, of course, as well. But just so much pressure by that front 7, forcing those running backs out wide, and then the closing speed and leverage by that second level of defense. Big for the Allen Eagles.
And down to 13, Colbert hits the pass off. Oh, looking for Shelby Walker. He had a little bit of separation there. Too much on it, though, from Colbert. Flag down again. Way down on the 24-yard line of Allen.
Bo Wells and Chance Melanson got a little tangled up. We'll see which way the call goes. It's going to go against the Eagles.
Struggled on the penalty side here in the third and fourth quarter here tonight.
A double move there by Shelby Walker. That's not where the penalty was, though. The penalty was on the other side of the field, completely away from where the ball went.
Holding on the defense. The hold was against an eligible pass receiver. The hold was in advance of the neutral zone on a pass. A 10-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Break for the Redskins. Bob Westerburn looking on here as the Redskins march it down at the 28-yard line. First and 10 for Lamar. Hand off to Wesley. Nothing there. Tries to cut back. Not much luck either before he is met up with Chad Adams.
When we talk about this again, the leverage by this Eagles defense, they're not going to give you anything on a busted, broken play, staying at home. And you see Wesley trying to navigate the waters there as he's running off to his right. But the pressure up front by Chad Adams. Chad Adams actually missed the tackle, jumps back on his feet, chases Wesley down, and comes up with the tackle. And the first down, negative play by that defense, pushes Lamar Redskins offense back to second and 15.
On the 33-yard line. Colbert over the middle. Pass intended for Shelby Walker. Good coverage from Allen. Miami Olatu and Cameron Hartsfield was in there as well. Third down and 15 now for Lamar. Allen side up, making a little noise. Lamar doing the same.
And it's an empty backfield, and this is normally where the Eagles will bring a little bit of extra pressure.
Timeout. Allen.
Allen takes the timeout. They're down to one timeout left now in the football game. So you saw that on third down. Concerns from Allen's side, obviously.
Well, I mean, obviously a very critical juncture in the game. 6 minutes, 28 seconds left. Third and 15. You got to believe the Lamar team is looking at this as two down territory. Trailing by 7 points. Decent field position, but you've got to make something happen here.